Okay, I'm going to Bundoora. Well, we're not going to Bundoora. What's the town we're going to, boys?
131 Carlsrue
on Melbourne Cup Day. Starts to get a rain on the cup. Always does, doesn't it? run, isn't it?
Carlsrue Station, the train line out front. Nice old place. That way to Melbourne, I think, is it?
No, this way,
Dad, to Melbourne, down this way. Okay. The other way to Bendigo.
Where would the sun be?
Repairs to be done, Lola. Bad little house, actually. Quite excellent. Look upstairs.
Watch this step. There.
There.
Oh, in too soon, though, as far as repairs go.
Just two rooms upstairs.
Yeah. See, all that roof was all intact the last time we were here. All those slates have come off.
Well,
it's going to be salvaged if ever. It's got a
touch of
money spent on it now. Otherwise, it'll be kiss goodbye to the slate roof, and that's worth the small fortune. No, that was always like that. I thought that was moved in the first.
Probably do as a base to work on from here.
Yeah.
Don't see any great problems with it. Well, is it? Yes, a well. Or is that something else? A great big well here.
Yes, I think it is the well.
Well, it's very dangerous to go near too.
Thank you.
is to the left there, you see.
Oh, well, can we get walk down there and have a look?
Goes back about 6 or 8 feet. Oh, it's got some winches and things in there as well. Yeah. The train line. It was a bit of a shock, but still. I think this is where the Daylesford track comes in here. Oh, this looks dark. It does. What are you saying? You're saying down there there was good yards, do you?
Well, I would imagine over there there would have been good yards. Because that's an island platform, so that would be where the Daylesford train
Daylesford. Well, yes, it would have too, yes. Well, hang on. That's the Daylesford track coming in there. Yeah. And yes, and that's where it would have come in. Yeah, for sure. Didn't realise that.
I see. You get the beautiful station and then the mountain behind it.
Yep. I've got that. Yeah. Well, let's have a little look up the line. Well, this obviously could easily have that train line still running on it. Even with the stitch.
Well, it's rained heavily. Rained heavily last night.
I know. It woke me up. There's a little water on the ground. It's probably a creek. Seen. Oh. Are we still on the track? Oh, there's a train sign.
doing spreading these things, isn't it?
What sort of tree is it?
No, it's a whole lot of caterpillars.
Oh, right.
Well, that runs next to that.
I wonder if this is owned by the railway people up to here.
No. Railways still own it at all. All the way through. So they still own the title holders. But just think they've been letting this a bit off. Did this farmer use it, or maybe they've just fenced it off to delineate areas?
Well, they've still got both fences running. So
yes.
Therefore, I would say they still have control of the land all the way through.
Well, they do, because they've got that,
Trentham.
Yeah, about four stations down on this line.
But it's a weatherboard, isn't it?
I wasn't going to touch it.
No. It's the other side, so we're on a formal little bridge here. Between that creek. It's a proper little bridge too. And we're on our train now, coming around from Daylesford up to Carlsrue Station. And this is us coming in on zoom lens now into Carlsrue. And we're here. Looks pretty good in the camera. Train would have come in. Our nearest neighbour.
Just walk along here.
do the roof, is it?
No.
What were they used at one point? Just tin cut the same sizes.
And up the top could have been done too. Well, it's high enough for any room, yeah.
This is the main group.
All right.
It's only a few bits.
Yep.
And then it's only this much here. So what do you reckon?
I think it could be done. Did it bring down that sort
of thing? Oh, no,
it's not a great hassle. But I think you're going to replace every slate up here, right? Most of them are broken. Even half of those ones are broken, beyond repair.
Well, I think we'll go down there.
It's very solid.
Right. Which way is that way up there?
Yeah.
What direction is that?
Bendigo.
It's Bendigo.
Thank you. sized place, Larry. Safe for us, but it's working too. Church of England, I think.
Oh, there's churches. Churches everywhere here.
Station just be round here, I'd say.
Just into the right
here. Right, the old house. Oh, that's an old railway house too.
Turn right there.
Right.
We'll go in and see how many trains a day go to Melbourne. Yes, I see that. I'm surprised at that. This Carlton is sort of major centre.
Well, you know, it's well, they think Carlton would end in Macedon.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the most interesting way it is. Let it go up that way a bit or not?
Go up around the station, that's a good
tidal races, of course. I just said to mother yesterday, would you come to tidal races?
I think you could go back now. Just turn left here, the wood cliffs, and just have a look at this little old bridge. There's the railway. I wouldn't go any further down there.
You wouldn't do. People haven't got any sense of adventure. I wasn't going down there anyway. Last thing I'd say is very interesting.
Then Phil Garley on the rails. Frontier boys tripping around the map, four wide now, then change field officer. Over on the inside, Tennessee Jack, and then change captain to be out of the straight. Ultimate aim, three off the rail, tracked up by Air Seattle. Then Great Vintage and Dancing Lord, one length away, Castle Town. Then came Azam, Mercator, and Diamond Bases, the faster boys, they head to the back of the track. I have 2,000 metres left to travel along the Marathon side of the track. And the Argonne confirmed 3/4 of a length. Frontier boys are second with about half the crown. The Bandit fourth on the outside, then Marrakesh the rail. A half the drumstabs getting one off the rail. Three wide was out, Crystalline. Then Silcardi racing inside, Vintage Crop. Out Pompeii was 3D. Then Young Pirate on the outside of Tennessee Jack. Outwider was Strike Chance and then Field Officer. Last in winner, Sub-Zero, a bit worse than midfield on the inside. Ultimate Aid was 3D and then Great Vintage for centre. Dancing Lord the inside, Cavalieri hooked out almost four wide. Then came Azam. On its inside, Mercator, a half to air, Seattle, Castle Town. And 2 lengths away, last of all, Diamond Bases. And she is 15 lengths off the lead at Tiarco Nick. 1,300 metres to go on the Boss of Melbourne Cup. Tiarco Nick by 1 length to Frontier Boy. 3 lengths away, third was the Phantom on the outside of Star. They were followed by Drumcat, Tetson Coaster on the outside of Marrakesh. Vintage Stop behind them, and they were followed down on the inside by Silcardi. Out first tonight was Zeke. Tennessee Jack taking up on the inside as they approach the bend. Young Pirate by, followed by Sub-Zero, one off the rail, dancing all of the inside. Field Officer was deep and then Great Vintage. Ultimate aim, Mercator, well back in the field, Cavalieri. Then came Azam. Further back as they come to the turn here, Seattle hard-ridden third last. Castletown second last and Diamond Bases last. Up to the turn, Tiarco Nick and Frontier Boy together. Three in front of the Phantom running on. Then drum taps over on the inside, Marrakesh and Farr both making up the ground. Demonstrated Tiarco Nick by a length. Frontier Boy second, Marrakesh the first, 3 lengths away, Farr. Then the Phantom, Vintage Top is running on an in-com test. Down to the 300, Tiarco Nick a length in front of Frontier Boy. Three away, Vintage Top selling the storm home from Tennessee Jack. Tiarco Nick in front, Vintage Top is storming home on the outside. Vintage Top on the outside, but Tiarco Nick in Mercator, and the Cup is going back to England. And Vintage Top has won the Melbourne Cup by 3 lengths to Tiarco Nick and Mercator. Then Great Vintage racing home for four. Close up in the field was Tennessee Jack, Frontier Boy. Then jumps out every chance, Marrakesh. Grand Nick, same as Arm. Sub-Zero, Cavalieri. Well back in the field, the Phantom, Young Pirate, Air Seattle. Castletown, Dancing Lord. Then Silcardi, Spike Chance. Ultimate aim and Diamond Bases has finished at the tail without Crystalline.
Well, mate, this is going to be one of the most memorial tours you'll ever have in any country you've ridden in. So you better go in there, enjoy it, and good luck, mate. And it's nice to see you. See the cup go overseas, and so hopefully next year we'll get a lot more of you guys over here.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mike.
Ronald Anthony Mike and what a training performance. Trevor well, they said he couldn't do it, Pete, but he definitely
came to my job. Yes, well, Dermot Weld has just joined us now. He's been besieged by the media as we go live around the world, Dermot, and back to Ireland. What would you like to say to the folks back home?
Oh, it was a great day for Ireland. And I just want to thank everybody for their help and everybody here in Australia has made me very welcome.
How confident were you going into the race?
I was quietly confident. When the 2 inches of the rain came last night, I was concerned. The horse did lose 7 kilos traveling out here, which is considerable, but he put it back on, and on Sunday morning when he worked, I was very pleased with him.
Did you take any heart to the criticism that was given about the preparation and the fact that it wasn't the Australian way?
That doesn't worry me at all. The same winners all over the world, so I'm used to criticism, but I do it my way.
Which way do you want to go, that way or that way?
Throughout the race, were you happy?
The other way,
since I was concerned over the foreign state, he got one to play start and was overall overcoming. Well, Drumcat 2, the other horse, ran a bold race as well. It truly is an international race now.
Yes, that's right. I mean, what did you say?
Look at the cup of the week. Are you under